Okay, it's week 6 of my Amazing Race 16 commentary, and Jeff should have definitely killed Jordan in the second week.
Jordan on Team Yenta?
No, Jordan.
Oh.
Jeff would have been better off if he left Jordan to drown in the lake and ran the rest of the race with a wet sack of flour.
Okay, so Jordan doesn't exactly have the eye of the tiger, but...
Yeah, it's more like eye of the three-toed sloth.
Whoa, what is with you this week, HR? Last week you barely mentioned Team Eagle and Squirrel for fear of getting mouser mail. This week you're taking shots at them right out of the gate.
I'm glad you asked, my nut-obsessed friend. Meat so stinks a bit. Hello, and I need a hug.
Hey, watch me appoint those things.
They're my new bodyguards from the security firm Poke'em and Spray'em.
Sounds more like a porn company. HR, you can't possibly expect this to end well.
Thank you, Nutstra Doomass, for your pussy squirrel opinion.
Mark my words, HR. Taunting Jeff and Jordan fans is just asking for a heap of trouble.
Whatever. I'm ready. Bring it on.
Can we get on with the commentary before one of those things accidentally goes off?
For the third week in a row, the Dippy Detectives have somehow managed to come in first.
Though they did lose their lead for a little while, they were one of the only teams who managed to get the correct directions to the detour location.
And the civilian escort didn't hurt either.
Congratulations, Louie and Michael, on another first-place win, but let's face it, once again, you benefited from a leg with no equalizers.
Unlike Team Eagle and Squirrel, this week's eliminated team.
Jeff and Jordan started the leg in last place almost 2.5 hours behind the Dippy Detectives, and with no equalizers in this week's leg, they were totally dependent on other teams making dumbass moves to keep them in the race.
While there were plenty of screw-ups this week, Team Eagle and Squirrel was just too far behind to be able to catch up. And when they arrived at the mat, Phil did his best Julie Chen impression, and by a vote of 1-0, evicted Jeff and Jordan from the race.
Jeff and Jordan, my former Big Brother housemates, remember that week when Jeff was head of household and the two of you spent your evenings in the HOH bedroom saying mean things about my sweet angel Michelle? Well, karma's a bitch, so enjoy the elimination station, losers.
HR, that wasn't very nice, and I thought you forgot all about Michelle when I hit you in the head with that hammer.
Yeah, well, that stung a bit, and I wasn't particularly interested in getting hit again, so I lied.
You need help, HR, and I'm not talking Dr. Phil help. I'm talking about a team of real professionals.
Screw you, Squirrel.
Will you two knock it off? You're starting to sound like Brent and Katie and dangerously close to becoming this week's wine of the week. Brought to you by the Wine Warehouse. Whether it's for a Copa party or falling off a wagon, nobody has more wine than the Wine Warehouse.
Except Jeff, this week's wine of the week winner.
What do you want to do? You have to go in a cave. You're claustrophobic. Have a panic attack.
It said cave, and I was like, I don't want to be stuck in a dark place.
Hopefully you have, I get rabies in there.
I don't really like heights, but oh, I have to go down there? It's going to be scary, I'll tell you that. I'm not pretending like I'm cool about it or anything. All right. Ciao.
Ciao.
I'm going to go a little slow. You're a pro. You're going to look like Santa Claus.
Okay, as wines go, that was pretty weak.
I know, but Jeff won't be here next week, so think of it as a parting gift.
Good gravy, let's just get to the dumbass move of the week.
And the nominees are...
Thank you. Champagne.
Leclerc Bryant.
I think we'll get champagne on our mat,
do we?
You know there's a town about 40 kilometers down the road named Champagne?
Jet and Cole for champagne. All champagne must come from Champagne.
We're good.
Joan of Arc, he carried the... and right?
She's.
Yeah. He carried all the animals.
She. That was Noah.
Oh, Noah's Ark.
Yeah.
Oh, please.
I wonder why we're in last.
Please don't.
Jordan and Jeff for Jordan Logic.
I don't hear anything. I don't think this is right.
Brett and Katie for Long Statue.
There it is. It's right here.
Oh, my gosh.
Rhyming.
Oh, my gosh.
We're about to fix that.
Go in here. Dad, you're not gonna rip it. Oh my gosh.
Allie, in my bag, there's some tape.
I'm looking for duct tape. I don't know how much that'll help, but we gotta try.
Give me another one. Just as much as you can on it. Okay, let's go.
Steve and Allie, for who needs AAA? We have duct tape.
My wife, before we left, threw it in there, says you can fix anything with duct tape.
Tattinger?
Oh, we can ask this cop.
Oh, there's that's the lesbians.
Oh, that's the lesbians.
They're pointing back that way.
Well, let's follow them. Merci. Yes, we caught up to the lesbians.
We're awesome.
This is it.
Yeah.
Go.
Let's do it.
Game on. Let's go.
Come on in, guys.
We didn't do the detour.
We didn't get a clue.
That's it. Passenger.
And Brent and Katie, we still haven't got a clue.
Like, how did they get here so fast?
I was wondering why we got here so quick. We did that twice now.
And the dumbass goes to
Brent and Katie, we still haven't got a clue.
Congratulations, Brent and Katie. When you show up at the finish mat once without a clue, we can let it slide. But when you do it 2 weeks in a row, well, that makes you Dumbass of the Week winners.
Well, that concludes another episode. We'll be back next week for our final commentary. Good night.
Hold on a second. What do you mean, our final commentary?
I mean, it's our final commentary. My agent called today, and we've been canceled.
Canceled? Why?
I don't know. Something to do with the guy who shoves his hand up our butts to make our arms and mouth move, not being happy with our low viewership.
You mean the guy with the cold hands?
That's the guy.
He can't just cancel the series in the middle of a season.
Why not? Fox does it all the time.
Yeah, and that's why we don't watch anything on Fox.
Oh, NBC.
No, Chip, we don't watch NBC because the network's run by the morons that screwed over Conan.
Oh, yeah, that's right. But Uncle H.O., what about all our loyal viewers?
Well, we thank them for their support, but there just isn't enough of them to justify all the time and effort that goes into making this commentary every week.
There's gotta be something we can do to get more viewers.
I think we've done everything we can do. Let's just try and go out on a high note next week.
Wow. First Jeff and Jordan getting eliminated, and now this. It's enough to make a squirrel throw himself on a power transformer.
That's fine with me. Just wait till after the next leg.